everybody, it's iGoDZoFLuiGii and welcome back to some more Pokémon World Online videos. And as you can tell, the last one I did was Cerulean Cave and Mewtwo. This one, as you can see by the title of this video, it's Empty Silver and Moltres. Now I'd like to point out that you can only get Empty Silver or Silver Town, which is the place I'm in right now, is when you require all 16 badges. So when you've acquired all 16 badges, you can then get the train or the rail cart systems here, the zipline things that you can get in most places. It only costs about £5,000 to actually get here, or $5,000 or Pokédollars, as people like to say, in game. But it's pretty much cheap, and pretty much this is the best place you can come to level up your Pokémon. If you want to see my team right about now, it's the Blastoise, Nidoqueen, Charizard, Pidgeot, Gyarados, and Ampharos. I kept Ampharos, I don't know why, I just filled up my 6 party gauge until I found a new Pokemon to take over it. A few things I'd like to point out first before we enter in this cave. You will have to do a quest, mind you, to get to the summit of where Moltres is. Now the link in the, not the link, my description of this video will contain the steps for this quest and how to do it and that, and basically you gotta go see the lab professor that's in this, and their research lab, and that's around about on the second level floor. Basically talking to her will start the quest. So what we're doing is showing you where her lab is and showing you one of the tasks that you need to do, which is like a hidden waterfall. I think that's task 3 or possibly 4. But you got to find a waterfall, and people do get confused because the image where you get the Pokemon World Online wiki, she points towards the wrong waterfall, and so it is pretty confusing. Okay, so you don't want to go that way, you want to go this way, mind you. I'm using Blastoise. Just something now, I don't have my membership. No, the membership ran out, and I haven't had a chance to actually update it. Now, you don't have to have membership, but I like membership because of the double XP, and it does come in good uses. Now, for some strange reason, when you walk around the grey area, you don't find any Pokemon. You might not, but to me, I have never found any in the grey area. I don't know why, like, they don't spawn there. But when you go into the light area, they do spawn. It's pretty weird, I know. Probably wrong lighting in the game or something. I have no idea why, but apparently that's that. But if you haven't already told, I got a new mic. I bought this mic for $20. Or £20, should I say, sorry, rather. I'm getting so confused in the Pokédollars now, I keep saying $20, but it's actually £20. Which is half price of what it originally was. It's like a HP Perillion headset, but it's good for doing commentaries and such as this. But I thought I'd try out on this one so I could see if it would be good for future videos that I'll do, because I don't want to use my Turtle Beaches all the time, because it's annoying how to set it up. Because you have Turtle Beaches X12s, you got to put the USB, the audio jack, and the microphone jack into the actual port system. It is pretty confusing. Now, I'd like to point out that the trainers on the first floor, they're just to interact with, okay? So when we go to the second floor, that's when there are challenges. So please do keep that in mind. I did do a bit of exploring while I did first come in, so you might want to look around. You might pick up some bit of story stuff. Just fun to get looking through into. The people that are in here, most of them will have high level Pokemon, and by that I mean over the level 90s mark. So do not get spun off, and don't like get confused when you first see the Pokemon they're with, because if they challenge you, you can see them the highest level Pokemon. With me, I usually only battle people in most common places, not places like here, because I'm not really like, I don't think I have a level 90 Pokemon yet. No, I'm nearly have one, so that's pretty good. But I don't think I have. Actually, I haven't explored up here. Let's explore! Yeah! Okay, absolutely nothing. Okay. I thought I was actually going to explore something good, but turns out, no, I didn't, so. Yeah, I suck so bad. I really am bad. Oh, the best thing about my Pokédollars is I don't get the actual bonuses as well, so I don't get double the money, damn it. I should have really paid for membership and then sprung back online, but I was just so keen to record this video because I won't be posting my walkthrough until later on, so I give you guys something to look forward to watch on my channel. I know that so far with the gym leaders of Pokemon Online, Dan, those have got tremendous reviews via views, likes and stuff like that, some comments. So when I post a walkthrough of that, hopefully that will bring in a lot of new following people. I know some people say they grew out of Pokemon, but that's them. Why watch a video of Pokemon if you grew out of it? Because some weirdo come on the video saying, I grew out of Pokemon, it's shit. I'm thinking ahead. Then why watch or search out a Pokemon World Online video if you don't like Pokemon anymore? Obviously, you are just really stupid. And those comments amuse me, because you must have some interest in Pokemon. You can't just do it out of spite, like go around and put hateful comments. That means you've got no life going for you in this game. It's pretty as confusing as hell. But yeah, I will be showing you the secret spot, the waterfall where you get through. Basically, if you're wondering what the quest is, if you haven't already checked the description, because most of you always comment without checking the description of videos, which I find really annoying. Always check the description of each video before you comment, because some answers can be put in there. But you have to find these Moltres feathers, which I should already have on me, because the last thing I've got to do is pull the feathers in the summit to release Moltres. Now, unfortunately, Moltres has no trainer, I don't think, but you cannot capture him. But I brought Pokeballs just in case. But I'm pretty sure you cannot, because if you could, everybody would be going after Moltres. So I don't think you can actually capture Moltres. So let's not get ahead of ourselves. So let's just use Ice Beam. God, there's so many Pokemon. I should really focus on Pidgeot, because it's only level 73, but I don't really want to, because no, my luck, as soon as I use it, I get a Graveler, a Graveler, a Graveler, and it's just so annoying. So yeah, 3 Moltres feathers. Supposed to be 4, by the way, but, you know, they're 3. They must have changed it. On the wiki, it's got a picture of 4, and really, it's just, no, it's just 3. It's confusing. You have to battle certain trainers actually get these. I'm not going to go after certain trainers. I'll leave that up to you. I just really want to show empty silvers through getting there and facing Moltres, like we did in when we faced Mewtwo, which that was a pretty epic battle. And if you're probably wondering, Moltres isn't going to be a level 50 like in the normal games. It's not going to be level 70 like Mewtwo. I'm going to save what its levels are going to be when we face it, but it is pretty weird. I can't explain it half the time. Okay, let's take down. Some kind of reason, Ice Beam is, I think it's super, it's super effective on Parasect, and I don't know why. I thought Parasect is a bug type Pokemon, so really, Ice Attack shouldn't be that effective. Is it Grass? I'm getting confused. Oh look, there's Brian Griffin's in the game. That's another game I want to play as well, Family Guy Online. I played it once or twice, but I want to play that game again, because it's so much fun, you know, because you play around as your own Family Guy character. You can make your character look like Peter Griffin if you're that much of a nerd. Oh god, I'm not even gonna. Oh, well, I was looking at thing, god, because I just got across, but now I realise now it's blocked off. Yeah, I've done the smart thing. God. Get away, you sound like Mewtwo, even though I defeated Mewtwo. The best thing about Mewtwo is you can reface that NPC trainer. This, after you defeat Moltres, you cannot go back to the summit at all. Which is pretty much upsetting. So let's go to Hiker Brian. Let's fuck you, Brian. Let's go through the cave. Now, luckily, I'm going to the Women's Professor Lab, because then the guy teleports us to Empty Silver's fifth floor, where the super trained Pokemon are, apparently, but I'm not quite sure. There was one trainer in here that you had to face for a last Moltres feather, and he had OP Pokemon, like, I'm not even joking, it's part of the quest as well. So you see his Pokemon as well, and he was pretty much OP. Again, I'm using the same pattern. I kept Skull Bash because it raised my defense. How good of an attack is that? If you look at my defense already, when I'm at level 99, because they're in the level 100, my Pokemon's going to be actually really maxed. So let's just close that down. We're so close to where we want to be, and so close so I can show you what I mean. Let's use Ice Beam. Sorry, Zubat. Had to be done. Just had to. Don't look at me like that, asshole. I'll fuck you up. Okay, I think when you go to the ladder bit now, there isn't a way out of it, nope. Maybe about level 40. I know some people say that empty silver has a strong Pokemon, but to be honest, I only come here with double XP, so I can actually get something worth out. Like, I would have got 6,000. God, I'm losing Harpetal. Well, at least I got level 88. I could really use Nido Queen, actually. Okay, so what I will be doing is... God damn it! Let me throw... Let me just use Aquatail quite... Aqua Affinity! If you're a fucking Minecraft person, then you might know what that means, but you know... I'm a total nerd. I love sort of stuff. Goodbye, Graveler. Goodbye, young warrior. God, I just want to play RuneScape. Okay, this is where you want to be for one of the challenges. It says talk to a waterfall. The picture on the wiki page points to this waterfall. That's not the right waterfall. It's indeed this one. Yes, it's on the same level as the second floor, mind you, but it's actually the one over. So ignore the picture. The picture lies. So if you type in Pokemon Online Empty Silver Quest, you get the Pokemon Wiki of it, and it will point to that one. It's in fact this one. And you may enter the cave behind the waterfall, which is basically this, which I already explored, mind you. Stands with markings on it. It does look like a champion master ball. It's gold. I would have just taken the thing and sold it online. Because I'm a total noob. I could have got double money! Look at that legit money. Legit, I haven't even sold a Pokemon yet in this game. Probably thinking I should. But then what would you do with that money? Absolutely nothing. Oh yeah, I forgot. When you exit it, you get teleported back to this room. Yeah. I think that's a glitch or a bug in the actual game, which no one has bothered to report. Probably because they're lazy. But yeah, this is what happens. So people want to, like, respond as you can. I'm not, because it doesn't really bother me. But it reports you down to... So you have to go back up the ladder bit. It's annoying, I know, but see, I forgot to mention that. I should never actually enter the actual cave. But wanted to show it off anyway. Actually, I wonder where I am. Oh, this cracked me up when I started playing it. Like, I was like, where the fuck am I? I swear this wasn't the entrance. But yeah, basically, you're back in the previous room on the second floor where you have to jump down from that cliff. Alright, let me just finish this, I'll show you quickly. Goodbye. I was just finding out as well, when you lose an NPC battle, you lose some rep. So yeah, that's something that's like literally, I was up there and now I'm down here. So now I have to skip that because I've got to go through here to get back to the... Oh, he has a red Gallo, that's shiny. Oops, I just said it. Oh baby, baby, my watch is gay. Yeah, literally, I tried looking at him. Gyarados leg, and literally I could not find it. I could not find a red Gyarados, so I gave up on it. I think there's a whole story of how it started in Pokemon Diamond and Pearl. A red Gyarados spotted a natural leg, something like that, and then they went off on a journey from the red Gyarados. I can't even remember if they actually found it or not. Oh god. Oh god. Oh, I'm in a battle. That's understandable. Never had that before. Around while the battles haven't even begun. Just give me my XP. Okay, now it should work. Yep, okay, I'm now getting to the lower mountain side. Remember to always type slash list if you want to find the Pokemon in this area. Don't type about say where Rabidash spawns at, or where do you find Rabidash, I should say. And I'm like, just type slash list space Rabidash and shows all Rabidash's location, or if I'm in a location like this, to type slash list, then go up. There's all the Pokemon in this area. And if I type slash list Abra, it shows me all Abra's areas, the ruins of Alpha. Yes, all of this. So you actually do not need to ask. Just type, it's a command. You're entitled to use it. Use it wisely. I was going to use slash refresh if I get frozen in that, so that's another thing. Okay, you want to talk to Professor Anna to start the quest, but I'm going to talk to this navigator, so we can escort us to the fifth floor, mind you. You can get there normally, but the guy won't let you through, because you got to talk to this nerd, I don't know why. But he will get you past the guard actually inside. So if you leave the building, you then have to go scale down and do that whole thing again. So yeah, these professors scientists will not battle you. There's only one trainer in here that has the last Moltres feather, and that's the OP guide, which is in the description of this video, containing all his Pokemon levels. So like I said, follow the guide. It does help, but I didn't want to record me doing the actual walkthrough because it was new to me. When I last played this on my old account, I don't think I ever got to Empty Silver. I don't even think I remembered Empty Silver. I played it back in 2010, so that's probably why. Student James doesn't battle you. And if you lose against this trainer, you have to wait 24 hours before you battle him again. So it's not 2 weeks. I was like, great, not 2 weeks. Even on the wiki it says you may have to wait 24 hours. So even the wiki wasn't accurate how long you had to wait for. I was like, great. So yeah, 24 hours and you can reface the trainer if you already lost him. It's not Student Jamie, by the way, it's this trainer down here. God damn it! Oh, I hate that Pokemon, I'm just going to finish off now. Because I tried taking this one out. A pain. Oh my god, half my health. Oh my god. It's still alive. Oh my god! Aqua Infinity! Jesus! My Blastoise is nearly gone! God, I hate that Pokemon. Gale Force. Oh my god, someone's got a deluxe name. We got a Crooniverse fanboy. Oh my god. Never seen that before. Never in my behaven. Yeah, he's got deluxe. He's got the name Deluxe. Right, it's just deluxe, ain't like deluxe 4, deluxe 20, so maybe he's not a fanboy, but still, never seen that before. Ethan, okay, Ethan is the guy who has the OP6 Pokemon with the last feather. Make sure you carry revives and Hydro Potion, because you cannot find a Pokemon Center or guy that heals your Pokemon in here. After you defeat him, he'll give you the last feather. And then talk to Professor Annabelle Jenkins, whatever her name is. Oh, I ran away from the battle. Yep, and Denna, I'm calling you Annabelle for short. And, oh, you didn't see Moltres there before? Okay, you can enter again, but search harder this time. She will heal your Pokemon in the first run, but not again. Ah, my bad. Okay, oh look, there's a cave! What's in here? Absolutely nothing, that was brilliant. Why put that in there? Okay, got my R attention. Let's go to the top of Empty Summit. And then what you want to do is push space bar. Yes. So you're probably wandering around thinking, what do I do? Space bar. The feathers in your backpack glow as a majestic bird swoops down upon you. Oh, and by the way, it comes up as a trainer battle. But no, it's just Moltres. Well, Moltres, attack. I will use Aqua Infinity! Booyah! When the fuck does Moltres learn Solar Beam? Huh. Okay, it's level 99. Whether you win or lose, after this, you cannot come back to face Summit. You cannot catch another trainer's Pokemon. So yeah, it forbids you to face this Pokemon down, and Thunderbolt, I'm finishing it. It used Sunny Day. Can I actually finish it off? No, okay. Paralyzed failed. One more. Ooh, level 90! My first level 90 Pokemon is Nidoqueen! I'm so excited! Mummy! And, Nidoqueen, I could have got double if I had a membership. Moltres flies away, leaving a feather behind. And that's how you get the actual Moltres feather, yes. We got Molten Feather, Dusty Molten Feather, the final Molten Feather, yes, they're Molten, not Moltres, and then you get the actual real Moltres feather. So the picture that shows all four of the feathers, it's redenamed, okay? It does look confusing. That's how you get four feathers. And yeah, I don't think you can face it again. Does it actually... No, it doesn't pop up saying it's too early or nothing. So yeah, you literally cannot. Alright, so that was pretty good. You can actually create a channel as well, but I've actually forgot how to. So if I ever did a walkthrough series of this, I'll create my own channel to add people in. But that's pretty pointless, because that's me. So now what we're going to do, go back and talk to her again. So yeah. Whoa, I've got a lot of this data. Meet me in the lab when you get time. So yeah, you cannot ever enter this ruins a bit again. But you can talk to the scientist, he's the assistant. Talk to this guy after recent research, blah blah blah. I will be using, however, my Charizard. Because I'm a total bastard. Thank you. Okay, I'm actually going to use paper. So, there we have it. There is empty silver, and now we have that Moltres. What you can do is go back to Professor Man's lab. I'm going to spend some more time leveling up my Pokemon. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, because I know I have, and I'm literally one of the best. You might see some more Pokemon Online videos from me. I will be keeping up the regular yearly download videos, as well as posting up some yearly gameplay footage and that. So please stay tuned as well when I actually do the walkthrough of this game. It'll be a complete walkthrough. That only happened with your support. So thank you everybody. Please watch out for my next walkthrough, which is Bully Scholarship Edition. Which will be coming soon. I don't have a release date for it, so please keep up to date with my Twitter account. Links will be in the description, as well as this video. So thank you everybody. Peace out.
Thank you.